Welcome to the class of editorial decode, and in this class I will be decoding for an inclusive humanities pedagogy written by Hemchandran Kara. Now from examination point of view, this will help you in general studies mains examination paper 2, plus this is important for sociology optional students. Now what is this editorial about? This editorial is about how the stream of humanities and the stream of science is being or has been dichotomized, and how this is affecting our understanding. This editorial is also about why and how there is a need to integrate both these streams. Now, this editorial is also about how there is a need to enrich the tools, to strengthen the tools of the humanities in order to understand the finer aspects and the nitty-gritties of a human. Now, in order to properly understand this editorial, we need to understand the difference between what science offers to us and what humanities offers to us, and how we have relegated the importance of humanities to the background. Now, as far as science is concerned, it helps us to feel, it helps us to touch, it helps us to know only the tangible. Now, the humanities, it operates in the domain that is totally abstract, that is totally untangible, that is totally that we cannot see. Now, science says it helps us to build laws, it helps us to build principles, it helps us to hypothesize the things that can be generalized, that can be known in the terms of mathematics. On the other hand, we have humanities, it focuses more and more on the human aspect. Now let us know about how the humanities focus more and more on the human aspect. Now take the case of psychology. It helps us to understand how a man thinks, how a man feels, how a man dreams, how a man becomes psychologically competent. It helps us to know and understand about the cognitive capacities and capabilities and the processes that are involved. And the subject of sociology helps us to know how a man interacts with his surroundings. The anthropology helps us to know about the evolution of the man, the culture of the man in the different stages of how he or she has evolved. Geography helps us to know about how the man interacts with the environment, how the environment puts certain conditions on the man and how the man responds to those conditions. Public administration as such helps us to know about how the man interacts with the organization. The subject of history helps us to know about how the man has behaved with his colleagues, with the other men, and how he has progressed. So the science helps us to understand about the finer aspects of a human being. Now this editorial, it is about for an inclusive humanities pedagogy. Now it is the responsibility of a social scientist to look into the deepest of the aspects that has remained unraveled till now. It is the duty of a social scientist to put up an encompassive picture, a holistic picture, a complete picture, an integrated picture of a man. Now, according to this author, the humanities, the way it is being pursued, it has not been able to delve deep, it has not been able to touch the bottoms to understand the man in holism. According to the author, there is a need to look into the aspects that has remained untouched. Though the humanities is connected to the political aspect, and because of that it is abhorred, it is hatred by the sciences. But that should not become a stifling block for the development of the arts, for the development of the humanities. There is a need to enrich the scope, there is a need to sharpen the skills that a social scientist have, so that we can weave a complete picture about the human, so that we can do the welfare for the human. Ultimately, the sciences or the humanities, they exist for making the civilizational process more enriched, more advanced, more welfarist. This is the basic purpose for the knowledge that we are acquiring, the knowledge we are gaining. Now, there is also a need to blend these two dichotomized streams. Sciences will be able to serve the humanity better when it will integrate itself more with the humanities. Now, the current situation in the universities is that we have devoid the science completely of a human being. And because of that, an engineer is not empathetic, an engineer is not compassionate. Engineer can only be knowledgeable, he can only quantify the things, but he fails to judge the things from a qualitative angle. An engineer is not able to look into the grievances of the people. An engineer is not capable to look into the pain of the people. An engineer is not able to look at the true value of a human being. So this is what the sciences are giving. So the sciences are offering us a knowledge that is deficit in the human aspect. The man is nowhere in the sciences. It is all about the laws. And in the arts, in the humanities, there is more and more and more focus on the human aspect. But the way the human is being studied in the arts, it is not being studied in the right way. The right way is an integrated way, not being biased. And being altruistic when you are conducting the study of arts. Being more engrossive, being more differing when you're studying the human being, only then you will be able to get the complete picture. So this was all for this editorial decode. You can subscribe to this channel. Name of the channel is EIS Mentors. You can contact me at 84594000 in case you're interested in buying the video classes on entire civil services preparation. And in order to avail the information of the classes that we are offering, please visit our websites eiasmentors.com and brainiki.com. And you can also install our application. Name of the application is Brainiki. You can find that application from Google Play Store and from App Store. And in case you have liked this video, do click on the like button, do share and comment on this video. So this was all for the day. Bye bye. Take care. Have a nice day.